minimalists.
Is there a certain point at which you can justify getting rid of something and replacing it with something different, even if the initial item works perfectly well? For example, I have baby clothes I have saved that I have used for my three children, and we are planning on having more children eventually. However, the clothes I have aren't necessarily what I would choose now if I were to go start over. So same with like something like dishes. Like if I have cups that work perfectly well, but I would really prefer to have a different sort of cup, can it really be justified replacing it?
You know, I dig this question, Ryan, because, well, it's a nuanced question. Because it seems to me that Becca isn't just trying to... I mean, she's being intentional about...
Yeah.
There are some things in my life, either my preferences changed or they've become more refined over time. There are some things in my life that I would prefer to have something different. Mm-hmm. And she's saying, when can I justify it? And I actually think that word is the problem.
Mm-hmm.
Because quite often, we can justify anything.
Anything, man.
Absolutely. Anything. I bet you if you give me 48 hours and a piece of paper, mm-hmm. I will write you a really good justification, one that's fairly sound, at least in my mind, because that's mm-hmm. the only person I need to really justify it
yeah.
to.
Yeah.
I could justify buying a Lamborghini, Ryan.
Yeah, dude. We could justify buying a helicopter. I mean, if we really sat there and looked for reasons. I think when it comes to that word justify, the question that I ask myself is, why am I trying to justify this?
And to whom am I trying to justify,
yeah,
it, right?
Man. Yeah, because if it's like, if I'm justifying something just to give myself permission to do something mm-hmm. that I typically wouldn't do, like mm-hmm. for me, that's the wrong reason for me to justify something.
Yeah.
And yeah, if it's to justify it to myself, I've got to examine that and really ask, like, what is it that I'm after here? With cell phones, for example, like I still got the iPhone 5. Hmm. It's slow as heck because Apple does not update. They don't fix the software. They intentionally let the phone slow down. Hmm. That came out in the news earlier this year.
Yeah.
So like they intentionally let the phone get slower so you can justify getting another phone.
Yeah.
And so I could justify that. I could look at that and say, oh, my phone's really slow. And I need to get that iPhone 10, or maybe I don't go all out and I get the iPhone 8. I don't know what happened to the iPhone 9, but I could go and get the iPhone 8, and I could totally justify that. It's got a better camera and it's going to be faster. I mean, those are two pretty valid reasons to justify. But when I really examine it, I wish I didn't have a phone at all, first off. So I don't really want my phone to be any faster. I don't want to be able to pacify myself easier.
Oh yeah.
You and I have talked about this. I haven't really pulled the trigger on it yet, but like I've talked to you about, you've talked to me about getting like a flip phone. And mm-hmm. I mean, I think that's what Leo Babauta still does. He still's got like a dumb phone, I guess is what you would call it.
Yeah.
But yes, Becca, you can absolutely justify anything. But I think with her question, man, it goes back to what you're talking about, dude, her preferences.
When she talked about, with her preferences, like the baby clothes, right? Or the dishes, right? And so the question that I wrote down for Becca, and this is a question that anyone needs to ask themselves, is can you afford your new preferences?
Yeah.
Because, yes, I mean, maybe I would prefer to own a Range Rover. I think they're beautiful cars.
Yeah.
But they're also like a $100,000 car. And I can't afford that preference.
Is the Range Rover, is that the one where they say buy two of them because one's always in the shop?
Yes. Yeah.
So really, you'd have to buy two of them if you're going to buy one.
Well, I could just keep my Toyota for when the, for when the Range Rover but then I'm going to be discontented because I'm not driving the Range Rover.
Oh, my goodness, yeah.
And so I think a Range Rover is just a gorgeous car.
Piece of art, man.
I really do think it's a piece of art. It's a moving piece of art. And unfortunately, I don't have unlimited money, mm-hmm. and so I can't truly afford it. I also can't afford all the times I would be taking it to the shop and all these additional costs that are embedded in that.
Well, I think the other thing too for me is like when I think about the Tesla, and I talked about this a few episodes ago, where you know Mariah and I, we had a savings account set aside for a Tesla. And those cost $60,000. Like the one I was looking at, it's all-wheel drive. It's the Model 3. It was like $60,000. And I was, you know, saving up. We had $10,000, $15,000 saved up. And I was thinking about dropping that money on the Tesla, just the $15,000. And that was something I couldn't do, because when I asked myself, you know, not only like, can I afford to buy this Tesla, but the question I asked myself was, can I afford to buy this Tesla and also not afford to build schools in Thailand?
So what's the other use of this money? Yeah. What's your sort of opportunity cost there? Right. Is this the best use of this money for me? Yeah. And it's not a judgment, by the way. If you were to say, yes, this Range Rover or this Tesla or these new baby clothes or these new dishes are the best use of this money for me, that's up to you to determine. Now, I like the way she looked at it. She said, you know what? If I had to do this again, would I buy these items again? And it sounds to me like the answer is no.
Yeah.
Now, if you're thinking about getting rid of something, that is the perfect question for you to ask yourself.
I love that.
If you're going to get rid of something, then ask yourself, would I buy this again? And if the answer is no, then yeah, you probably want to get rid of it. Now, if you're talking about upgrading the thing, or the word she used, which I like a lot better, replacing the thing. Because to me, replacing is far more important than upgrading. Because we get to a point where, okay, let's say your phone just smashes into 1,000 pieces, right, Ryan? Are you going to upgrade it? Well, maybe. Maybe you need a different version, or just the newer version that's out.
Yeah, or maybe that version that I broke isn't available anymore.
Right.
Yeah.
Or maybe you can just replace it with something else. Maybe it's the dumb phone. Maybe it's another iPhone 5 that's used. If you're replacing it, that is often intentional. And then, so the question is, what am I going to replace this with? Is
that's a much better question, man, I think. Because it's like, you, instead of asking yourself, am I doing this to upgrade? Like, you know, Becca needs to ask herself, am I doing this to replace the items? It's a, like you said, it's much more intentional.
Yes, indeed. So, Becca, I would love to send you a copy of our book, Essential. It is an essay collection with 150 different essays here. Jordan, which camera is it? This one? All right, beautiful. It's an essay collection with 150 different essays about simple living, about intentional living. There are two chapters in here in particular that I think you'll find a lot of value in. There's a chapter about minimalism. It's the first chapter. And there's another chapter in there about stuff. And so when you're talking about replacing your stuff, getting rid of your stuff, some rules around the stuff in your life, we have those rules in Essential. So, Sean, if you could reach out to Becca and send her a copy of Essential, either the book version, or if you like our podcast, you'll love the audiobook version of Essential, or if you just want the ebook, we'll be happy to send that to you as well.